The Tale of Sir Robin. So each of the knights went their separate ways. Sir Robin rode north through the dark forest of Ewing, accompanied by his favorite minstrels.
Bravely bold Sir Robin rode forth from Camelot. He was not afraid to die, oh brave Sir Robin. He was not at all afraid to be killed in nasty ways. Brave, 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 brave Sir Robin. He was not in the least bit scared to be mashed into a pulp, for to have his eyes gouged out and his elbows broken, to have his kneecaps split and his body burned away, and his limbs all hacked and mangled, brave Sir Robin. His head smashed in and his heart cut out, and his liver removed and his bowels unplugged and his lungs compressed and his bottom burst off and his
knees. That's enough music for now, lads.
Conclusion.
Brave Sir Robin ran away.
No.
Bravely ran away.
I didn't.
When danger reared its ugly head, he bravely turned his tail and fled. Yet brave Sir Robin turned about.
I didn't.
He chickened down. Bravely taken.
I never did.
He beat a very brave retreat.
Oh, God.
Brave.